It's a writing challenge, writer's group, today on The Right to Focus. Project stage, musing, which means no drafting, no rough shape, no sketching of ideas. I thought of a lot of different writing-related things today. I spent time thinking about my current project, my next project, my upcoming trip that is going to interfere. All thinking, so much thinking, that it threw off my original schedule. Other things are interfering as well. The things we let interfere. I thought about that as well. And that led me to writers' groups. People in writers' groups say everyone should join. Writers too far away from groups want to be in a group. We're communal animals. We want to associate with people. We want to be in our community. But I'm not much from writers' groups. There, I've said it. My prejudice is solidly up front. If you love your writers' groups, don't continue listening. If you have a love-hate relationship, as I do, keep listening. If you don't know what you think about writers' group, maybe you want to listen very closely. Writers' groups can be extremely helpful to newbies and gonna-bes coming back into the dream after giving up for years. The best ones give lots of practicable information and support for those who need the extra push to improve skills. Practicable is different from practical. It's able to be put into practice. The worst writers' groups turn into social clubs and vain chest-pounding. Yes, you've been there, haven't you? We cringed together. The larger gatherings like conferences and long weekend seminars smash together quality and narcissism. Cost of the conference, the room, and travel can be prohibitive, so we have to weigh the outlay of funds with the perceived abundance of information. Sometimes the balance weighs in our favor, sometimes it doesn't. See, I'm being honest. The local meetings trend to aspirations unfulfilled. Most locals don't have enough membership to weight the balance toward professionals. The local promotes critique groups as the primary method for skill improvement. I have found critique groups as hit or miss. If you love your critique group, stop listening. The successful critique groups have members who start at the same level. All the members work hard for the goal of publication, and while they achieve it at staggered rates, they do achieve it. The unsuccessful critique groups start at varied levels with not one member published. Members bring work each month and members come erratically, which means that few hear a longer story in its entirety, only a chapter here or there. The critique therefore focuses on ticky details and misses the overall story arc. Collapsing critique groups give vicious responses designed to pamper the critiquer's self-esteem rather than improve the submitter's text. Neither one are professionals. Not the critiquer and not the submitter. Members focus on denigrating published writers. They pick apart supposedly flawed sentences in a published book rather than look at the scenes and sequels of the events. If you manage to join a writer's group or a critique group with helpful pro writers, the newbies desperate for the rarefied air around a real published author turn into groupies rather than protégés. And the helpful pro writers, they usually only emerge for special occasions because they're too busy writing to meet a deadline. Regional writers groups, or those based in major metro areas, have the best chance of offering the information and support that writers need. These groups can draw a large enough membership to make the programs worthwhile. They generally are not specific to any genre, or the group is specific, but members fudge the meaning of genre just to have the salt after interaction with other writers. I once drove 2.5 hours down and 2.5 hours back to a monthly meeting in a metro area. The meetings leaned toward skill building and network creating information. I tried to find a critique group, but no critique group within an hour of my residence was open to a newbie member. In the last months that I attended these monthly meetings, which were already becoming more and more difficult to manage, the meetings were not very informative. One of the very last meetings that I attended had a supposedly highbrow ivory tower writer reading a story about pigs slavering for copulation with a boar. No, I'm not kidding. I'm not exaggerating. I was unhappy for a whole half hour and longer. I stopped going to those meetings not long after that debacle. Then life took a bad turn, and I dropped out of the active writing scene for a decade. Only in the last couple of years of that decade did I manage to get snippets of time here and there that gradually built into a story. These snippets kept me from spiraling down in a true tailspin. I avoided the crash, thanks be to God. When I returned to active writing, I tried to find a writer's group. I tried local. I tried regional. I found better info online. And online, I found help to seed the idea that I could participate in the ebook revolution, and I found professional writers to follow. An online chapter may miss the social and networking aspects, but they can be very helpful. Yet somehow physical attendance means that I invest myself more in the group. Anyway, for quite a while, I was floundering and flailing around, yet staying afloat. Personal networking does trump online interaction. Venturing to the major writing group closest to my former home, I discovered, oh my God, more ivory tower people. Acid-tongued critics. Bombastic wannabes. Nothing and no one self-publishing. Nothing and no one traditionally publishing. I attended a couple of seminars hosted by the writing group, but I dropped out of the smaller meetings, and the monthly meeting never fit with my work schedule. Midweek and late, just like the critique groups. I moved in 2017, and in my new location, I tried to find a writer's group. I found the vanity people. I found the ivory tower worshippers. I found newbies trying to gain admittance to the ivory tower and felt so sorry for them. I found wannabes rather than gonna-bes. You know, wannabes, they talk about writing, but they never write. A year and a half after my move, I may have finally found a group. I attended the three-hour initial meeting of a Sisters in Crime chapter. It was primarily an informational meeting, but the organizers left me with a great feeling that this may be the one. I shall see. Keep writing goals in mind when seeking out a career-based group. Don't go just to be going. Listen only to the pros, not to the wannabes. If you can't personally interact with pros, find the people who give beneficial advice online. Don't waste your money or your time. For writers, time is money. That's lesson 53. By the way, I want to end with my current self telling you that I did find a great writers group, that Sisters in Crime chapter. The pros, though, are traditionally published, but they're willing to work with me, and I'm indie. I read Mark Twain again today for my inspiration. Does that make three quotations for him? He sounded a lot like Anton Chekhov today. Don't say the old lady screamed. Bring her on and let her scream. The next quotation I saw was Flannery O'Connor. I blame her, by the way. She said, I write because I don't know what I think until I read what I say. That's good, but I think those words deserve blame for this post. Thanks for listening to The Write Focus, a podcast for writers at all levels hosted by M.A. Lee with assistance from Remy Black and Edie Runes, all from Writers, Inc. Books. Our focus is productivity, process, craft, and tools. Show notes for this and other episodes can be found on thewritefocus.blogspot.com. Write to us at winkbooks@aol.com. Our podcast episodes are running short this month, but usually they last as long as it takes to fix a quick dinner, drive a short commute, or take a brisk walk. Daily in April, we're bookcasting Write a Book in a Month by Remy Black, 2 in the trilogy Inspiration for Writers, copyright 2020. Take lessons from today's episode and write on. It's a writing challenge, writer's group, today on The Write Focus. Project stage, musing, which means no drafting, no rough shape, no sketching of ideas. I thought of a lot of different writing-related things today. I spent time thinking about my current project, my next project, my upcoming trip that is going to interfere. All thinking, so much thinking, that it threw off my original schedule. Other things are interfering as well. The things we let interfere. I thought about